Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today's update will cover topics like new information about the plumbing under my country, the plumbing that controls everything. I will also be talking about the Blue Lagoon, how safe it is to be there or not. And I will be doing a little earthquake tour to see what's going on under my country, what is normal and what is something different. But I'm starting with the earthquake that struck Lake Kleifarvatn this morning. It was a little over magnitude 3, so it got the city shaking a bit. And it took over the headlines for a while. But as for me, this was not a surprise. This is a place of interest. And like I mentioned the other day, Professor Ármann Höskuldsson is of the opinion that this system has already woken up. And those earthquakes are just a part of that process. The location of the earthquakes, they were no surprise either, or under the lake. An earthquake in 2000 that occurred under the lake as well, it drained it of over 20% of its surface area. It has since recovered for the most part, and that the same seismic event, it created hot springs in one corner of the lake, or just around here, seen from the drone. And this was shot from another hot spring that came into being after an earthquake in 1929. So this area has been changing quite a bit over the last 100 years. And I just uploaded a video from this hot spring yesterday. And I'm linking to it. And where those earthquakes took place, I was filming there with the thermal drone just last year. It turned out to be a bit tricky that day. But I still have the files and I will try again there when it's colder. And that trip is coming up soon. And the Kleifarvatn area, it has always fascinated me. It's so much around here than meets the eye. And those earthquakes this morning, they support what I mentioned in my last update. The earthquake activity is still decreasing west of Grindavík, but increasing east of the town. And the last inflation period around here was in 2022. So there is magma on the move around here. So this might just be just another milestone for this system to wake up fully. I think so. But when, I can't say. It could be days and could be years. So let's move to something that can be explained a bit better. Or new information about the pipelines under the peninsula. And this is my own diagram. Or the simple version to connect this to the landscape. We were led to believe for a while that the magma source powering the eruptions was from a depth of 15 kilometers, the mantle, but the chemical composition of the magma was always a bit confusing, even the same eruption could come up with different chemicals. And we have never got any clear picture about this, just bits and pieces. But what we got now is perhaps the most logical explanation that I've heard so far. Or a magma chamber powering all the events since 2020 and it is situated under the mountain Faradalsfjall. And as it started to pressurize first in 2020, the first move was to knock on the doors by Svartsengi, several times actually, or three failed magma intrusions. Then we got those three eruptions in Faradalsfjall before the activity shifted back to Svartsengi and we know the rest of that story. Four eruptions from this small but extremely destructive magma sill where the magma accumulated in actually very little quantity but led to all those disasters. And this major change in this new diagram is the location of the main magma chamber. And the scientists believe that it is fed from several sources from the mantle. That might explain the different chemical composition in the lava from those eruptions. But the remaining question is, did the Faradalsfjall magma chamber feed the eruption in the so-called Eldvörp craters during the 13th century? Or was that eruption fed from the offshore magma chamber, like I mentioned in my video about those craters and I'm linking to? So once again, we get one answer and several new questions. And since this channel is also in a way my personal quest for answers, I can fully admit that to get to know the plumbing system under my island might be my ultimate goal because it might explain questions like why do I often see the Reykjanes Peninsula shake After some of those larger earthquakes in the Bárðarbunga volcano, directly above the mental plume, and I tend to see Bárðarbunga volcano as Iceland's heartbeat. And let's relax in the Blue Lagoon now. And the big question has been, will this smaller magma chamber that fed the nearby eruptions lead to an eruption by the Blue Lagoon facilities or the power plant? And the Mother Earth has so far made over 10 attempts, but all those eruptions, they took place elsewhere, all due to this obstacle there that I cannot explain myself, but let's say that there would be an eruption there, like it looked like on November 9th, when the Blue Lagoon was evacuated for the first time, and I think it's very likely that first we would get such earthquakes that this whole area would be evacuated. So it is very easy to overcook the story about the Blue Lagoon into something that it isn't. But there is no denying to it. There is a certain risk there, of course, that has been met with gas detectors, evacuation plans, and the trained staff that cooperates with the civil defense and the police. And if this magma seal by Svartsengi fills up once again while the eruption is ongoing, then we have yet another scenario that we haven't seen before. But I think it's logical to assume that the eruption just powers up for a while and finds its balance again like now. But this series of events will not stop until the inflow to the magma chamber under Faradalsfjall stops. And since there are very likely several sources feeding that tank, it might take some time. And Icelandic shield volcanoes overall, they have a big story to tell about the time that those kind of eruptions can go on. So let's see what is going on under other parts of the country. I often get the feeling that my island is breathing like a living creature. Especially like now when I see the seismic activity increasing throughout the country. Those chapters, they can go on for some days or weeks, then they fade out. But they can leave us with some indications about where to look for the next major events. And judging from this chapter we are in now, I'm focusing at Vatnajökull glacier that covers many volcanic systems. Bárðarbunga volcano just sent us a magnitude 3+ recently. But it is the next door, Grímsvötn system, that looks way more suspicious now. And Bárðarbunga could actually trigger that event, since those systems are so related. And we should actually hope for the next big event to come sooner than later around there, because those frequent eruptions are quite harmless, while the others are not. And the volcano Askja I covered recently, we have huge increase in land uplift there during the past 2 months on the GPS point that is just by the lake. But we don't see any drastic increase in seismic activity. That could mean that there is plenty of room for more magma to accumulate there. So Askja volcano remains as a wild card, or this depression in the land with Iceland's deepest lake above an inflating magma chamber. And if something gives in between the magma chamber and the lake, I would like to be elsewhere. So let's finish this where we started by Lake Kleifarvatn again. This seismic swarm, it took a few hours. It started quite strong, but seems to be fading out as I suspected. So this morning was perhaps just a little wake-up call for us, and also a wake-up call for the trouts in the lake. And whenever I mention this lake in my videos, I get the question in the comment section, is it okay to fish there? So I'm making that into the tourist tip of the day. For 65 euros, you can get almost unlimited access to 35 lakes around the country. This fishing license covers this lake as well, and this can be fantastic entertainment if you are driving around Iceland. Not to mention the free meal. And I will of course use my upcoming trip to the Reykjanes peninsula to do more filming. But I just had lots of work to finish here in the north. The roads have been slippery since it's been snowing a lot around here. And just 2 days ago I was filming the largest ski jump platform in the world. I will publish a full video about that soon on this channel. But I have a trailer in my Icelandic channel and linking to it now. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.